Another of the many incidents during the Cuban Missile Crisis that could have led to an accidental nuclear war took place more than 2,000 miles to the west of Havana, in California. Back then, just as today, the U.S. routinely test-launched ICBMs from Vandenberg Air Force Base towards the Kwajalein Atoll in the Marshall Islands. President Kennedy met with General Thomas Power at Vandenberg in March 1962 to observe a test launch. But October 1962 was different. Because of the Cuban Missile Crisis, the Air Force had rushed nuclear warheads to Vandenberg and installed them on 9 of its 10 test ICBMs, changing their aiming point from the Marshall Islands to targets in the Sino-Soviet bloc. Adding those 9 extra warheads seemed like a good idea at the time. That left one missile to test, and it was launched right on schedule the night of October 25th, 1962. Now, fortunately, the Air Force got it right. The missile that flew was tipped with a test radio instead of a nuclear warhead. But astoundingly, no one apparently thought to ask, what if the Soviet Union, either from its base washers or by intercepted communications, learned that the U.S. was mounting nuclear warheads on its test missiles? Then what would happen if Soviet agents suddenly learned that we had just launched an ICBM out of Vandenberg? Perhaps we should have considered delaying further testing until the crisis had passed. There is no record that any civilian leader in Washington was asked if they wanted to cancel the test, given that missile launches might be misinterpreted in the middle of a nuclear crisis. Apparently, no one even thought about it. After all, the officer in charge had a schedule to keep, and that was exactly what he did, strictly according to plan. Now, history and humanity are fortunate that Kennedy and Khrushchev were able to make a deal ending the Cuban Missile Crisis. Yet it is clear in retrospect that there were serious limits to safety, risks of something going horribly wrong, risks of dangers being ignored, and risks of standard operating procedures being followed even when they were inappropriate in the middle of a tense nuclear crisis.